What's up, school fans? Bapak Ibu Kipadila, and we are back, back with the man, the myth, the legend, Adiani. And sekarang kita live dari Louis Coffee di Pondok Pinang.
Yep.
One of my favorites, man.
Underrated. Very good.
Kita minum latte dulu sebelum kita ngomongin NBA Finals.
Dan fun fact, Louis is the name of a bird.
Fun fact itu tadi.
It's the owner's bird.
Siap.
Tapi,
let's dong kita mulai, Tom.
Yeah.
Oleh-oleh dulu dari Phoenix kaos.
Ini udah pernah kita bicarain ya.
Udah. Dan ini sombokan biar Adi mau bikin konten terus sama gue. Kalau nggak terus nggak mau bikin konten lagi sama gue. But once again, shout out to Louis Coffee. Thank you so much for letting us do this right here.
Always.
Kita selalu di sini, tempatnya selalu di Louis Coffee. So kalau kalian ada waktu, kalian stop by kesini sih. Asik tempatnya, kopi juga enak. Nah, sebelum kita masuk ke NBA Finals yang akan mulai tanggal 3 nanti ini. Tong, gue penasaran pendapat lu aja nih. Jimmy Butler kemarin 3 poin, season on the line.
Win or go home.
Win or go home, bisa 2 poin kalau dia mau. Dijaga sama Opa Horford. Bad shot or good shot for you?
In the case of the Miami Heat, it was the only option.
Okay.
With semua pemainnya underperforming, sadly. Okay. Kyle Lowry, kemudian Tyler juga cedera. That's the only way to go. That's the only way to go.
Yeah, me too.
buat Jimmy Butler mungkin ya, he'll try and live with it and he'll take it. And it's Jimmy. He's a big game player, gitu kan. Nah, oleh karenanya dia dipercayakan apa untuk mengambil tembakannya itu. Tapi ya, you make some, you lose some. That's basketball.
Yeah, gue juga bilang kalau mereka masuk overtime, kan mereka udah habis bensin juga sih.
Yeah.
I think they're done. So, prediksi kita playoff hancur lebur. Kita berdua harusnya rematch final tahun lalu, tapi ternyata dua-duanya kalah di semifinals.
Tapi itulah makanya ini disebut Santa.
Prediksi santuy. Tapi Tong, game 1, Boston Celtics melawan Golden State Warriors. Are you excited though for this matchup?
Yeah, I'm excited, tapi juga melihatnya second best team. It's not the best in class in the NBA right now, tapi second best team. Both made it to the finals. I mean like setelah Januari kan ajaib. Apa yang terjadi buat Boston Celtics?
Tapi super ajaib.
Tapi momentumnya itu bisa diteruskan. Dan itu yang menurut gue sangat positif. They got people hurt, tapi they get through it. Tapi mereka belum ketemu lawan yang menurut gue sekelas, sekaliber the Golden State Warriors.
Okay.
Ya, kita sempat bilang di season preview, Golden State Warriors they can do their utmost best, bisa juga hancur. They can be a great championship contender, tapi juga bisa hancur. Tapi yang dibuktiin mereka step up semua, ticks all the right boxes. Bahkan death line up-nya udah yang baru. Gue melihat juga
PTSD with the W.
Gue melihat juga they got a mission and they want to complete the mission. I don't know. Maybe the stars are aligned, tapi menurut gue kan waktu di preseason kita sempat bahas untuk juara Golden State belum tentu.
Yes.
Tapi kalau gue melihat, ya setelah back to back game 7 buat Celtics agak merubah juga konsep gue bahwa ya mau nggak mau, percaya nggak percaya, istirahat itu penting.
Yes.
Tapi kelamaan juga nggak bagus.
We'll see.
So that's why the first game itu sangat tricky.
Okay.
Because you have Celtics all guns blazing, but they have to travel juga. Tapi they're in good shape. And the Golden State are a bit, menurut gue mereka bakal agak-agak rusty lah di awal-awal. Ini yang bisa jadi momentum swing juga buat the Boston Celtics in the early first, second quarter. Dan ini yang bisa jadi keadaan yang kurang menguntungkan. Walaupun di Chase, I think they're unbeaten.
I think so.
Unbeaten in the playoffs, right?
Yeah.
Jadi itu ya, yang menurut gue susah banget ditebak.
Okay,
gue like unders, man.
Of course. Because this is boleh dibilang ini adalah dua tim dengan defense terbaik sih sebenarnya.
Nah itu juga yang mungkin orang bakal nggak terlalu, mungkin kalau yang ngikutin Golden State banget, ngikutin Celtics banget. Okay, Golden State they have one of the best firepowers.
Yes, offensively.
Tapi mereka juga nggak tahu bahwa statsnya they are the second best defensively.
Yes, gue juga shock sih baru tahu.
Boston Celtics are third best.
Oh, it's not the best.
Huh?
I thought they're the best.
Oh, they're the best.
I think they're the best. I think they're number one defensive
so,
ratings.
So number one, number two.
Yes, number one and number two defensively.
Jadi kan, you have both teams yang mungkin kadar offense-nya menurut kita on TV when we see them, they're the most dangerous offensive team. Tapi padahal yang membuat mereka bagus adalah defense. So
I mean, they got Draymond, they got Andrew Wiggins.
Yeah, Wiggins.
Two-way player, Steph Curry.
Yeah. Dan Otto Porter Jr. is also a two-way player.
He's pretty good. Hopefully he's healthy. And obviously, health is important.
Important for both teams.
Yes, yeah. And Boston Celtics, sebenarnya kalau gue lihat mereka main kayaknya 23 hari terakhir itu every other day.
Yeah.
Jadi gue juga gak tahu mereka masih ada bensin atau enggak nantinya. But they're still young. Yeah. Tapi of course, Robert Williams kita gak tahu
healthnya.
Marcus Smart playing like with one leg probably. One leg, yeah. Tapi itu nanti kita akan bahas nanti. Tapi gue harap mau nanya lu kan nih, Golden State Warriors menurut gue lumayan impressive.
Very impressive.
Mereka bisa masuk ke NBA Finals sejak Clay kembali lagi. Clay, 5 straight finals I guess.
tapi gue aja juga, itu kita bahas deh.
Yeah.
Because I don't think Clay is top Clay.
Oke, nanti kita bahas. Tapi yang pasti gue mau tahu dulu dari lu adalah seberapa impressnya lu dengan tim Warriors tahun ini.
Very impressed. Bahkan to an extent, overachieving.
Okay.
Karena menurut gue, mungkin Steve Kerr juga akan front office juga akan kaget dengan apa yang dicapai. How they dismantle the Dallas Mavericks, walaupun memang matchupnya kurang enak buat Dallas gitu ya. But how they dismantle the Mavericks, I think they even give that game. They give that game. Just to make it pretty.
Oh yeah, dan juga biar cuan di Chase Center.
Yeah, tapi the way they dominate, the way how the Mavs play defense yang justru menjadi bumerang buat mereka juga gitu kan. I think the way they dismantle the Mavs is the most impressive.
Okay, wow.
Because coming in banyak yang bilang bahwa Mavs can do the upset. They can't.
They cannot.
They can't.
There's too much firepower.
They're too slow, Mavs. They're too slow.
There's no big man.
Yeah.
There's no big man. Dwight Powell nggak penting banget.
That guy.
Kevin Looney was just killing.
Looney was the best. I think Looney di playoffs ini, I think he's one of the best players yang Golden State have.
Gua actually main bilang harusnya final conference-nya MVP-nya adalah Kevin Looney for me.
Yeah. Benar. Setuju gua.
Dari series-nya lawan si Memphis.
Yeah. Makanya gua bilang in the playoffs he's the best player. Dulu kita sempat bercanda gitu kayak Looney, what is this?
Hot text gua final MVP final Kevin Looney.
Yeah.
Hot text gua.
So, berarti the Warriors akan menang dong.
Oh iya, kalau Warriors benar. Tapi gue kalau Warriors benar, kalau itu Warriors benar. Karena gue nggak bilang Warriors.
But okay.
That was if the Warriors win, that's the big if. Tapi Boston actually played really well against si Boston selalu. Lawan si Warriors selalu.
Yeah.
Mereka
they split the series, eh?
Split the series this season. Tapi sejak tahun 2019 itu Boston menang 6 dari 7 pertandingan terakhirnya mereka. And they are battle tested. So how do you like the Celtics' chance? In the
they have a big chance. Bahkan di first game they have a big chance to upset the Warriors.
Okay, so first game
I still think the Warriors will take it, tapi it's not gonna be that easy. Unders, maybe just 4-3 points.
Well, tapi kalau menurut lu kelebihannya Boston apa nih daripada si Golden State Warriors?
They work hard. Defensively they're set. Al Horford juga I think he's proving that ketika
Pak Horford kita enggak perlu
ketika
Pak Horford
set your goal to do something right in one season supaya maybe this could be his last season juga. He's doing everything yang benar-benar membuat Celtics jadi caliber championship caliber. Dan this for an old guy, he's doing the thing. He's not just the glue guy, tapi sometimes he's the main guy.
Yeah, he's
for that offense to tick.
Kita masih nggak bisa lupa tentang dia step up waktu on Giannis.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
That's crazy.
That game was crazy. He was dunking on Giannis, man.
That's crazy.
He was mad at that time.
Lawan Bucks. I mean lawan Miami Heat. He steps up. He delivers.
Main 14 rebound juga kalau game 7.
Yeah.
So he's 35 years old.
Yeah.
Playing like crazy right now. His first NBA Finals.
Yes. After how many?
141 game. Yeah. Di playoff. Most. Di between pemain-pemain NBA, of course, setelah 15 season juga.
Well deserved.
Nah, tadi kan gue sebenarnya mau nanya, sebenarnya gue salah nih bridgingnya.
Sebenarnya
harusnya bridgingnya adalah Celtics itu has zero experience in the finals, pemainnya Celtics. Sedangkan pemainnya Warriors 123 game experience in the NBA finals.
Tapi Celtics is Celtics.
Yeah, and then superstarnya, dua scorernya, itu gapnya 8 tahun. Bedanya dan ini adalah katanya the largest gap ever in the NBA Finals.
Yeah.
So, itu harusnya pertanyaan gua, apakah Celtics ada chance untuk bisa ngelawan Warriors ini yang one dibilang superior dan maybe healthier dan juga rested. Of course more rested.
Yeah.
So, what do you think, man, about the Celtics' chance in the NBA Finals?
I still think they have a big chance.
Yes,
yeah, yeah. The games are gonna be tight. Ya ini nggak ada. Menurut gua yang blowout udah
over. Yeah, gua blowout bosen banget dan nontonnya.
It's over.
Oh my god. Kayak, gua struggling sih nonton Final Conference. Gua struggling.
Yeah,
one of the worst ever.
You have a few game sevens, like one of few game sevens in hockey, and like the hockey fans are like winning because there are a lot of good games in the game seven of hockey. Gitu kan. Sedangkan NBA blowout.
Mm-hmm.
We were expecting Suns bakal close game as a blowout.
Yeah.
We were expecting a lot of close games yang jadi blow up gitu kan. Tapi kalau untuk series Boston lawan Golden State, it's gonna be all tight games.
Okay.
Yeah, more blowouts.
Kita berharap itu biar kita nanti
seru. 7 games.
Iya, 7 games biar juga orang-orang hype banget untuk NBA Finals. Tapi kalau lu mau lihat match up antara kedua tim ini, match up siapa, jaga siapa yang lu mau lihat?
Smart on Steph.
Ooh.
Smart on Steph.
That's gonna be fun.
Yeah, Smart on Steph. Cause like I don't think Steph enjoys playing with Smart.
Ya, kok gue sempat lihat sih statistiknya online sejak tahun 2014-2015 Smart saat jadi close. Tapi gue benci banget sih stats close defender itu, gue benci banget sih. It's not accurate sebenarnya, tapi Smart itu berhasil nahan Steph Curry itu 29%.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
Dan Steph, I mean he's older now. Are you worried that si Smart will shut down Steph in the series?
Tapi Smart one-legged. Even one-legged aja, he's still a great caliber player gitu kan. And he'll make Steph work hard. Tapi ya itu tadi, the offensive click dari Golden State itu menurut gue terlalu bagus.
Okay.
So, I don't know how you contain the options of like shooters yang they have. How to make them uncomfortable. Karena justru menurut gue juga, when you got White for the Celtics, tapi Golden State always has this apa ya kemampuan untuk membuat role dari player yang sebenarnya step up dari bench misalnya gitu, kayak untuk menggantikan Smart, karena kan Marcus cannot play the whole series fit, tapi kalau mau dipaksa injections and stuff bisa gitu kan. Tapi keunggulan dari Steve Kerr tactically adalah untuk bisa who's the coach, Mike Brown, untuk bisa mematikan who's their next option. That's the most impressive thing about the Warriors.
I mean Steve Kerr and Ime Udoka, dua-duanya murid dari Greg Popovich. This is gonna be a fun.
So everyone is Popovich's assistant.
I know, man. Everybody.
Even our favorite Budenholzer.
Yeah, and even Becky Hammon. So, man, look.
Jadi Popovich is the Ralph Rennick of football. Basketball.
So, kalau lu lihat seorang Ime Udoka, rookie coach, bisa menang multiple game 7, and now in his rookie season masuk ke NBA Finals. Kalau lu ngeliat seorang sosoknya Ime Udoka, apa sih yang paling suka?
I think first and foremost motivator.
Okay.
Yeah, kan? Karena kalau kita lihat clipsnya dia di locker room, he's a good speaker, good talker, man managementnya bagus. Motivator penting karena timnya juga a variety of players yang veteran sama muda gitu kan. Sama apa ya, dia gak punya pressure.
Okay.
He doesn't have the reputation as in Steve Kerr. He have to win.
Oh yeah, I see.
The finals lawan very apa ya, least experienced coach. So the pressure ada di Steve Kerr menurut gua. Dan ini yang membuat Udoka bisa menikmati semua match yang dia jalanin, bahkan game 7s. Tapi tactically dia sound. Dan he knows what to do, what to expect, who's his go-to guy juga. And on rotation sebenarnya dia paling banyak 8 pemain. Bahkan kemarin lawan Heat 7 menurut gue. And that's all yang dia pakai gitu. Tapi di 7 orang ini dia percaya bahwa the Celtics can go on a great run yang membawa mereka ke finals.
Dan dia juga adjustment-nya cukup bagus sih menurut gue sih.
Yes.
In-game adjustment-nya. Nah, let's talk about my boy, Jaylen Brown. And of course, Jason Tatum.
Yeah.
Orang pada dulu doubt them. Like, wah, ini dua gak bisa main bareng nih. Mereka gak akan main bareng. Turns out, they made it to the NBA Finals. Menurut lo, seberapa banyak nih load, offensive load yang mereka harus ambil sih.
Sangat
di
banyak.
NBA Finals untuk juara.
Yeah, in terms of offensive load, the two best options ada di mereka, dan untuk melawan Golden State you need to be on your very best juga belum cukup gitu kan, harus perfect di setiap execution. Half of the points will come from the duo, dan kalau mereka nggak step up untuk benar-benar bermain di atas kemampuan juga susah buat Celtics. Tapi menurut gua they can do it. They have the pedigree buat itu tadi, steal a game di Chase Center. We never heard that happen before di season ini, tapi itu mungkin bisa dilakukan sama Boston. I think their road record is 8-1.
8-1? Yeah. Oh, maybe 8-2, bro.
8-2.
I think 8-2 this season, yeah. This playoff.
Yeah, that's, so, they're pretty good, though. Yeah, makanya. Jadi, menurut gua, ya itu tadi gua juga nggak bisa nebak game 1. Itu gila sih, menurut gua. Game 1 itu penting banget, karena untuk ke depannya kita bisa lihat chances buat Golden State menang atau enggak. Karena kalau game 1 diambil sama Celtics, it'll probably be over by 6.
Yeah, kita udah tahu lah blunder game 1 dulu. J.R. Smith di Oracle Arena. Mirip lah, deket-deket lah. Tapi ya emang penting banget sebenernya game 1. Dan sekarang ini juga game 1 kita gak bisa tebak ya. Susah banget keluar. Gak kebaca lah kira-kira siapa yang akan main. Tapi kalau lu ngomongin step up, right? Talking about somebody stepping up. Kalau lu dari benchnya Celtics dan juga benchnya Warriors, who will you like to see to step up in the series?
Kalau misalnya udah bisa balik, Gary Payton. I love that player.
Yeah,
Gary
he's still game time decision for game 1.
Yes, Gary Payton, I think. Kalau ada Iggy juga, walaupun juga masih, I think he's back in training.
I think so. 7 NBA Finals.
Iggy is always going to be an important piece. I think for the Celtics, White is an important piece. Pritchard is an important piece. Tapi ya itu tadi, the death lineup barunya Golden State. I think it's also, that's very very dangerous.
Yeah, I want to see Jordan Poole sih. Gua penasaran Jordan Poole gimana
main di NBA Finals. Jordan Poole, I think it's the same boat with Klay Thompson sih. Menurut gua Klay udah comeback, tapi dia belum, ataupun mungkin juga karena udah injury-nya cukup panjang, dia juga udah agak tua kan nih. Jadi kayak menurut gua it's not the best of class from Klay, tapi itu cukup.
Cukup lah game 5 main cukup, jago kan? Juga
kan? Ya, tapi kan itu sebenarnya kalau kita lihat Klay akan lebih jago dari itu. Tapi apakah Klay yang sekarang ini cukup untuk bisa ngelawan Celtics? Gue masih agak ragu lah.
Kalau gue sih lebih ke konsistensi untuk Klay. Klay kadang-kadang kayak one game jago banget.
Ya,
turun. Waktu lawan Memphis parah banget. Memphis berapa kali nembaknya nggak masuk-masuk terus. Jadi menurut gue lebih dia ke konsistensinya dia aja sih. Apakah dia bisa konsisten atau enggak di NBA Finals sih nantinya untuk Klay. Tapi next kita akan bahas apa lagi? Oh, yang lagi rame, Raymond Green lagi biasa. Karena jadi podcaster, banyak pendapat, banyak bacot. Jadi
kelamaan ini pandemi.
Iya, pandemi.
Everybody wants to be a podcaster.
Iya, balas-balasan tweet sama Kevin Durant. So basically si
Raymond, I think Durant is in on it.
Probably annoyed banget sih karena KD dua kali menang MVP final, so now Draymond like saying something like, si Steph ini harus menangin MVP Finals biar solidify, memperkuat legasinya dia untuk di karir NBA-nya. Kalau menurut gue,
I don't think he needs it.
Yeah. Tapi kalau menurut lo, apakah penting untuk menang Finals MVP? Padahal kayaknya dia udah menang cincin juara gitu loh.
Yeah, that the most important thing is the ring. Individual stuff buat Steph kayaknya nggak. It's not him.
So what is Raymond talking about?
Juicing stuff up.
Pemain-pemain NBA sekarang ngomongnya the new media.
New media.
Him, Patrick Beverly. Your boy, Patrick Beverly.
Pat Bev itu pure entertainment. Entertainment gold.
Sekarang menurut gue, Pat Bev 1 juta habis, man.
Dia punya angle yang menurut gue sesuai sama karakternya. That's why they're milking it. And he's milking it too.
Actually dia ngomongnya pinter sih, kecuali si Fitri aja. Si Shram, ada truth-nya dan enggak. Menurut gue, he knows the game.
He knows the game really well. He's a vet and he's been through wars. Dan dia tahu lah. Dan dia orang yang, orang yang tepat lah untuk ngomong-ngomong kayak gitu. Kayak kalau misalnya itu orang lain, mungkin kita akan bilang he doesn't understand what he's talking about. Kalau kayak Draymond, kemudian juga Pat Bev, kayak Draymond.
JJ, I love JJ Redick.
The Redick is more lebih apa ya? Control.
He control.
Dia tahu juga marketnya dia di mana. Gitu.
Yeah, true. Yeah. And of course, ngomongin KD. Ini KD sama Kyrie sedih nih. Dua mantan timnya di NBA Finals, mereka duduk di rumah dan mereka satu-satunya tim yang di sweep tahun ini, Tom. Satu-satunya tim di sweep.
I think that's one of the ya gue nggak kaget karena gue nggak sama sekali rate the Nets, not like you.
Yeah, not like me. I pick the Nets to win the first series.
Gue nggak pernah nge-rate mereka gitu kan. Dan apa ya kalau lo bilang shock of the season mungkin buat beberapa orang is how they got swept.
Okay.
Ya kan? Yeah. Kayak you have
KD. I'm shocked. Yeah.
Minimal lo bisa dapat
satu lah.
Yeah, even like the Pelicans can do better.
Yeah.
With CJ McCollum.
Yeah.
And Ingram.
Yeah.
They can do better.
Jose Alvarado.
Yeah.
Tiba-tiba mataharinya hilang. Tiba-tiba mataharinya hilang tapi yeah, Jose Alvarado.
Yeah, makanya kayak the Nets kemarin hancur banget, tapi the Pelicans bahkan menurut gue untuk season depan pun without Zion they can do what they can because they have a good coach.
That's true. Yeah, they got a very good
very
coach.
Well respected juga.
Really good, yes. Yeah. So, udahlah kita gak usah panjang lebar, kita juga bingung mau ngomongin apa lagi. So, let's get to it. Give me kira-kira skenarionya yeah. Menurut lo untuk yang jadi juara.
If the Celtics get healthy, they can make this game into a 7 series. Itu yang mereka mau tentunya. They have the capability, walaupun Golden State has that chase center effect going on for the first game. Itu sangat penting untuk series ini, makanya ketika nanti balik lagi ke chase center for game 7, I think that'll be enough. Tapi in terms of how the Celtics can get a result from game 7 di luar kandang mereka, mereka juga very credible, because the Bucks, the Heat,
yeah,
ya kan?
Battle tested, man.
Battle tested, that's why.
KD, Kyrie, Giannis, Butler, out semua gara-gara Celtics.
Yeah, because they're a good team.
Yeah.
Tapi ya, yeah, tadi gue bilang it's just gonna be enough for the Golden State Warriors to get that 7-game.
Wow.
And win
menangnya di Chase Center berarti
Chase,
nih?
Chase, yeah.
Wow, so you got Warriors?
I got the Warriors in 7.
Finals MVP?
I will go with Looney.
Just Kevin like, Looney.
Yeah, he deserves it.
Yeah, he does deserve it though. For me, yeah, the big thing for me is Celtics harus stay healthy sih.
Stay healthy, yeah. That's the X factor.
Karena kalau ada si Robert Williams itu mainnya beda banget.
Beda, benar.
Beda banget langsung defense-nya. Tapi obviously now they need Derek White to be consistent juga.
Yeah, but ada yang gue raguin sih, Derek White to be consistent, and I think Steve Kerr has that antidote to like not make White a factor kayak di series sebelumnya gitu. Ya, tapi makanya yang gue bilang yang beda dari Celtics adalah they haven't faced a coach like Steve Kerr, assistance-nya juga semua berpengalaman, dan how they set up the team. Sekarang menurut gue lebih fleksibel justru ketimbang tim ini ada KD gitu.
Ya, karena juga bahayanya itu Draymond juga bisa jadi coach sama Steph.
Dan apa ya, they buy-in into that offense.
Yes.
Even the role players, they buy-in into that offense yang membuat tentunya you can deny the shots, you can deny the space, tapi they'll still find a way to hurt you.
Yeah, Dub Nation seneng nih dengerin ini.
How good you guys, Dub Nation.
Tapi yang pasti apa menurut gue, Derek White untuk jaga-jaga kalau Marcus Smart kenapa-napa.
Yeah, like, yeah. Pasti rotasi sih. Yeah, karena menurut gue Smart nggak bisa main the whole series,
We'll see.
Yeah, I think White can.
Of course, Peyton Pritchard need to step up as well from the bench. And who else is benching si Celtics?
If they stick to seven guys, susah.
Grant Williams needs to be hot, man. Yes. He needs to be hot. He needs to hit his 3-point shots.
He can do that.
Yeah, he can do that. Tapi juga kadang-kadang dia nggak bau juga.
Tapi menurut gue itu tadi all games are gonna be close. First game is under supposed to be.
Biasanya lawan public tuh. Kalau public semua under tadi udah over. Tergantung aja publicnya di mana.
Yeah, just that. The Chase Center has got that apa ya, harus konsisten juga vibesnya karena menurut gue sama Oracle masih agak kalah sih.
Tapi ini akan gila sih menurut gue sih, pasti NBA Finals they gonna go crazy, they gonna give everything they got, man, they gonna scream dari on top of their lungs pastinya. Tapi gue it all depends on, gue bilang Jaylen jadi X factor for gue. Jaylen Brown gonna be an X factor for me. Okay, Tatum I think for sure gonna get his 30 points a game. Tapi Jaylen Brown, kalau dia nggak bisa step up, apalagi dia juga tugasnya defensively, probably gonna guard. Dia akan jaga Klay Thompson juga nantinya. Yeah. Jadi dia akan kerja keras on both ends. We need Jaylen untuk kayak bisa 24-26 points sih, at least per game-nya, agar si Boston ada chance. And for me, pada denger pasti prediksi gue, Boston.
Boston Celtics.
In 7, winning it in Chase at Chase Center
nantinya.
Oh yeah,
that's crazy.
Banner 18. Wow. Banner 18, rekor baru nantinya di NBA.
I think you guys, this is the second time they meet in the final.
1964.
Bill Russell. Wilt and Bill.
Yes, Wilt nih, anak-anak kayak Wilt nih main sini. Anak kayak Wilt, Otto Porter Jr. mencoba untuk membalaskan dendam ya bapaknya. That's gotta be his son, right?
Itu dah, identically there's no need for a
DNA test. Ada DNA test lagi, mirip banget. Orang yang tato ya mungkin bisa tenangan dikit atau Boston Celtics bannernya. Mau apa tadi, mau apa? Ya, menurut gue Celtics kalau mau menangin, this is I think their best chance. Next season gue nggak tahu mereka bisa sejauh apa lagi. Karena Eastern Conference is very tough.
Very very tough.
So this is their time. This is their time to win. So Boston in 7, walaupun nanti tiket pesawatnya mahal banget. Mahal banget untuk nontonnya, pasti bulak-balik.
Naik Greyhound aja lang.
Tapi capek banget pasti dong itu. Gila. Itu 6 jam dong terbangnya. Boston to San Francisco is gonna be crazy. But I'm excited, hopefully bisa masuk Amerika dulu yang penting. Yang penting bisa masuk Amerika dulu, gak di interview 3 jam lagi kayak kemarin. I'll be there for game 3 di Boston.
TD
Garden.
It's one of the best.
Yes, gue udah lupa sih, gue terakhir udah 5 tahun yang lalu, 4 tahun yang lalu sih kesana sih. So, apa lagi yang mau gue omongin sih? Oh, jangan lupa gue nobar game 1 di R66. Promo dulu biar lagi nonton sama Om Helmy. Legend semua sih, Agus Mauro.
Itu kayak siaran NBA back in the 90s.
Di SCTV, lu nonton SCTV juga kan? SCTV gila ya. Dulu NBA Finals ya.
Mereka di stadion.
Bisa di
Chicago, sering di Chicago.
That was like Michael Jordan's time. That's crazy. That is crazy. Jadi kalau kalian mau lihat gue nggak tahu juga gue akan ngapain nanti di sana. Cuma diundang datang.
Gue pengen lihat Reinhardt Tawas. Om Reinhardt Tawas.
Om Reinhardt mah gila.
Masih sleek back gitu.
Asik nih.
Pat Riley.
Pat Riley abis dia asli sih. Tom. Warriors in 7. Warriors in 7.
Yeah.
Celtics in 7. Kalian apakah bisa tulis di comment section di bawah. Once again, Tom. It's been an honor. Thank you so much. Dia gue datenginnya kalau lagi sebelum regular season, sebelum playoff, pas sebelum NBA Finals.
Dan kita akan
IBL playoff mau nggak? IBL playoff.
Oh iya, Zoom, main Zoom.
Zoom ya. Yeah. IBL playoff. I don't know.
Kita akan kapan? Agustus. September.
Agustus. Artinya Agustus. I don't know. So far sih, gue sih jadwal Agustus.
Agustus
sih. Yeah, I'll be back in August. I'll be back awal August.
Yeah.
So we'll see. Kalau emang sebelum mulai gue udah balik, kita langsung ketemuan di Louis Coffee lagi nanti. Kita bikin langsung IBL preview playoff,
World Cup preview,
no, FIBA Asia. Oh, World Cup bener-bener, World Cup bola ya. Boleh tuh, channel sebelah gue. Tapi gue gak ngerti tentang
bola ya. Tom, nice man,
stay healthy.
Yeah man,
keep. Gila dia, gue gak ngerti jadwalnya dia sehari bisa jalan 3 kali sih. Yeah. Orang juga robot nih.
Robot.
Dia juga robot.
Well, we're doing badminton now, man.
I know, right? Gila, volleyball, badminton, futsal, sepak bola, semua, basket.
Yeah, you name it.
Yeah, man, yeah. So crazy. But, yeah, guys, thank you so much for listening to us. And
all the bullcrap.
I know. So hopefully you guys enjoy this episode. Kita seru-seruan aja di sini, prediksi kita. Ya, lo tau lah hasilnya biasanya kayak apa.
Melenceng
banget ya. Tapi once again, thank you so much though for listening to us. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you guys again in the next video. Peace out.
Peace.